Testimony that Muhammad is Rasulullah requires following, ittiba', and any action through which a person takes as a means of nearness to Allah is not acceptable except with these two conditions. Except with these two conditions fulfilled. Sincerity of intention to Allah and following to the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The meaning of you testify that there is no Quran except Allah means that you have to confess and attest with your tongue and heart that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, the most mighty and most majestic. And the meaning of ashhadu, it means I attest and testify in my heart, uttering on my tongue. Because the shahada is an utterance and relating of what is in the heart. And if the one who is making the testimony in his heart is a dumb effort whereby he cannot utter it, then this is sufficient because of his incapacity. The testimony with the tongue is not sufficient. Due to the evidence that the hypocrite testified the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but on their tongue, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them,
I think it's in that pile over there.
With their tongue, that which is not in their heart. So
they
used to come to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, affirming that they testify that he is Rasulullah, and Allah knows that Muhammad is Allah's messenger, yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testifies in the Quran that the hypocrites are lying. And that Allah knows that they are lying. He said it in the Quran. Then, la ilaha illallah, we explain that. Then the question
of
how come you say, how come it is said, la ilaha illallah, there is no God except Allah, yet that there are gods which are worshipped.
Right, I'm going to use this paint to make more sense.
And Allah has referred to them in the Quran as Aliha, as
over
gods.
Here,
and
the, same
the worshippers of these gods, they also refer to them as their gods. Qala Allah Ta'ala, take for example the following. Surah Hud 11:101. فَمَا أَغْنَتْ عَنْهُمْ آلِهَتُهُمُ الَّتِي يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مِن شَيْءٍ.
Oh, he's talking in
Arabic. They wrong them not, but they wrong themselves. So their آلِهَ,
and then he translates it into English.
So their God, other than Allah, whom they invoke.
Or he'll say it in Arabic, and then he'll tell you what he said in English. Kind of like what they do in Spanish and English.
To their lot but destruction. Also, take for example that Allah referred to their God as also God in 21:43. أَمْ لَهُمْ آلِهَةٌ تَمْنَعُهُمْ مِنْ دُونِنَا لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ نَصْرَ أَنْفُسِهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ مِنَّا يُسْحَبُونَ. Or have they آلِهَ gods who can guard them from us? They have no power to help themselves, nor can they
okay,
be
I'll,
protected
I'll hold down the show
from our torment. So from our discussion of the grammar earlier, we came to understand that the negation there is something missing grammatically, which implies the truth. So these gods, therefore, of them are gods, but for
so there are bad gods that you aren't supposed to worship.
One. And therefore, it deserves nothing of the uluhiya of divinity.
Yeah.
And the
only guy you're supposed to worship is
Allah. Again, what we read earlier in Surah Al-Hajj 22:62. Listen to this carefully, please. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّ
لَا يَدْعُونَ
مِنْ دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلُ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. That is because Allah, He is the truth. The only God that exists, who has no partners or rivals with Him, and what they, the mushrik,
what defines
Him is al-batil. It is batil, falsehood. And verily Allah, He is the most high. So if a mushrik comes to it,
which
he worships and bows to it, prostrates to it, and humiliates himself to it, and may even go unconscious by it, then his worship is futile. And that which he is worshipping is also batil, it's false. Except Allah. And Allah is the title of the Lord, the most majestic. No one
I thought you were just going to paint or something. I didn't know you were going to get the blanket
Allah,
all that.
Which follow from it, and it does not follow other names. Except
we gotta
in wonder,
a cat
and that is the saying of Allah in Surah Ibrahim 14:22.
إلى صراط العزيز الحميد الله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. This book which we have revealed unto you, Muhammad, in order that you might lead mankind out of darkness into light by the Lord's leave, to the path of the Almighty, the owner of all praise. Okay. Then came what? Allah, to whom belongs all that is in the heavens and earth. So their names came here, Almighty, owner of praise. Then came Allah, to whom belongs all that. However,
I just bring
the honor of his name here, Allah, is grammatically referred to as Badal from Almighty. Badal from Almighty. Badal means a noun equivalent. A noun equivalent. This is the meaning of Badal, it's a grammatical one. And it is not an attribute, because all the names